Spiky Bits.
Hey guys, MBG here today with a look at the newest White Dwarf. This is issue 2 of the weekly format that just debuted last week. Not exactly sure if it's going to continue, but it's on the books for at least 4 of these things, so we will endeavor to cover them all. This one, of course, is about the new dwarfs, and this very interesting submersible flying gyrocopter kind of ship thing here on the top. So we're going to take a look at it. But just real quick, just some tidying up to do. Of course, this is the new weekly format. It's about 32 pages for the actual White Dwarf itself. It's $4 retail, so that comes out to about 13 cents a page or so. And it basically covers all the new releases. If you're not familiar with all the new rumors and the hubbub and stuff, it's basically a way for the studio to the White Dwarf team to deliver the content, I guess, without the leaks and such that have been occurring all over the internet and the pictures and things like that. So, if anything, it's only leaked a week out or something like that. It's printed in the UK. It's a really really nice kind of cardstocky cover here. It's pretty thick, you know, so it won't get ruined if you throw it in your bag, you know, a couple of times. It should be fine or whatever. It's very interesting. Format. It's got some content, and it's got an extra paint splatter article, which I kind of like. So it's kind of the best of both worlds. It's like a White Dwarf light with some, you know, some content and also a showcase of the new releases. Now remember, the old White Dwarf used to be roughly 150 pages, and about 50 pages of it was the new releases, and it covered all the new release stuff. So it's interesting to see. I mean, I guess they spread out that 50 pages of advertisements over four or five issues, depending on how many weeks are in the month, etc. So it kind of remains to be seen how that's going to work. But let's take a closer look at it. Check out the format here. Here's the opening salvo for the team. Basically, the traditional White Dwarf team with a few changes stayed on board for this. Then it goes into the actual contents itself. Of course, the new releases, which take up majority of the magazine. I like this out now, online only. You know, they definitely plan that. Phil Kelly's got some stuff to say in here. Haven't seen anything from Jervis Johnson yet. Like I said, there's a paint splatter article, some different, just different stuff in here. It's majority fantasy, which was refreshing to see because we haven't seen a whole lot of fantasy content in a long while. So that was always good to see. So let's kind of take a look. A lot of this is going to look familiar to y'all. Like, obviously, the showcase for the new releases, this is the Gyro Bomber. Like I said, it's a very interesting design. I mean, it stays true to the normal White Dwarf, or the normal Dwarf Gyrocopter kind of feel, but it's got more of a cockpit. It's still got that open-topped kind of look, but it definitely looks like something that's seafaring, that you wouldn't expect to see in the sky, perhaps, but I still like it. I know a lot of people are on the fence about it, but I mean, that's what's great about Games Workshop, is they just put out, like, this crazy-looking stuff, and you either like it or you don't. I really like this guy because he would definitely fit in a 40k army or things like that, because he's kind of squattish looking, but he's also got a lot going on. This is easily convertible into an actual, you know, 40k weapon and things like that, and I'm sure he's great in game. Which leads me to my next point, where they're basically putting rules in this thing, which of course I haven't gotten to. But anyway, somewhere in here there's actual rules for the model. So now, if you haven't kept up with the Splash release schedule, they're basically putting out models before the actual rulebook comes out, which I'm sure we'll see for some 40k releases in the near future. And then what happens is they put rules for those models, not the complete rules, but most of the rules, in the White Dwarf. So you have to buy the White Dwarf, basically. And then the book comes out, like, week 2 or week 3, which, you know, they're trying to keep their... They're trying to keep their sales from, like, peaking and stuff like that, and trying to keep it more flatline. But honestly, I mean, I see the strategy, but I think it's going to alienate more people than it has a better effect for them. But I mean, again, that's the company's policy, and it you know, that's their thing. So like I said, here's the second paint splatter article. The first one, you know, being in Warhammer Visions, which was a great one on Tyranids. This one, you know, doors aren't my cup of tea, but that's pretty cool. And then it kind of goes into the actual new gyro kit itself, with all the different things like that. And like I said, there were some rules in here for these two new releases. Also, it showcases the new army book that's going to be coming out for the dwarves, which will be, I guess, basically next week, the 15th? So, you know, a lot of changes going on, a lot of things happening, and well, it's not a big issue, but you know, for $4, you can't really go bad. I mean, it's got content, it's got new release preview, so it's not too bad overall. I think I think weekly you might want to pick up the one that you know is for you. And of course, it's got an ad here for Warhammer Visions, which came out last week, which is the monthly magazine. And of course, issue 3 will be on sale next week. So I don't know. It is what it is, and this is what we get until they change it. It's at least going to be a month's worth of these things. They've put it on the books out to distributors and retailers, so we know at least this is how the release schedule is going to be for at least a month. So definitely weigh in and let us know how you feel about it. So that's it for this one, guys. Make sure you stay in the trenches. Subscribe to this YouTube channel. Check out the blog, spikybitsblog.com, and listen to our podcast, forgethenarrative.net.
Spiky Bits.